out like a straight line. Press the brakes hard from the corner ahead, but release them before you turn in. If you've slowed down enough, you won't get too much oversteer. Sliding's fun, but it isn't always fast. Road surface and elevation changes have a huge effect on stopping distances. You need to brake much earlier for this downhill gravel turn. Small taps on the brake should be enough for fast technical sections, but focus on straight line braking whenever possible. Straight line braking isn't always the fastest way, but it's usually the safest. Try braking later to find your limit, and when you're ready for the next step, check out the trail braking lesson. Braking hard will shift the weight over the front wheels, increasing grip when steering and giving you sharper turning. Accelerating will transfer the weight back over the rear wheels, allowing you to get the power down. To flow through winding sections, use gas, braking, and steering inputs to move the car's weight around. Weight transfer is less distinct on loose surfaces, so you'll need to make stronger inputs to trigger the same effects. Okay, slow down for the corner ahead, turn in, and give the handbrake a quick hit to tighten the line through the corner. For tighter turns, like hairpins, hold the handbrake for slightly longer, but be careful to When you get a flat tire during a rally stage, you have two options. Stop to repair it, or limp the car to the end of the stage. Sometimes driving it out is your only choice, like when you don't have a spare. And it may be faster to limp it home than to spend the time making the change. When you're driving with a flat tire, the car is going to be unstable and prone to understeer and oversteer. This can be especially problematic on two-wheel drive cars when the puncture's on a driven wheel, like when you get a rear flat on a rear-wheel drive car. When a tire goes flat, it loses its shape and it gets floppy. If you keep driving on a flat, the tire can come right off the rim or rip apart, which can lead to bigger problems. The faster you drive, the worse it is. There are a couple of signs to look out for that tell you you're driving too fast on the tire. First, you'll feel a vibration through the car that gets worse with speed. To help prolong the life of the tire, try slowing down to a speed that reduces that vibration. Second, a flat tire is noisy. That's because it's out of shape and it's rubbing in the wheel arch. Again, reducing speed can stop the noise and help keep your tire from breaking apart.